Truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
Yes.
All right, consider yourself under oath and have a seat right there. And then pull that microphone in front of you, point it right at your mouth, and then you still have to remember, even though there is a microphone, you must project when you speak.
Okay.
Can you give us your name, please? This is for your last
name. Natalie Lynn, L-I-N-N.
Natalie, how old are you?
20.
Are you from the Akron area?
No.
Where are you from?
Broomfield.
Okay. Graduated from what high school there?
Field High School.
Currently live in that area?
Yes.
Are you currently working?
Yes.
You've been working in the restaurant kind of business?
Yes.
I'm going to talk to you about November 2014, okay?
Yes.
During that month in 2014, where were you working?
Cordobella's Italian Eatery.
And where is that located?
Right off the Towner Circle.
Do you recall how long you've been working there?
At that time, probably about 4 months.
And what type of job did you have?
I was a waitress.
Did you work with a woman by the name of Jody Sugg?
Yes.
She became a friend then from the bar, or from the restaurant, I'm sorry?
Yes.
So on November 15th, 2014, on that date, were you working at Cordobella's restaurant?
Yes.
And what shift did you work there that night?
From 5 to close, so whatever time we closed that night, I think around 11.
You closed around 11. Did you leave at that time?
No, I had to wait for Jody to close up the bar, and then me and her took my boss home, and then we had to return back to work because my boss forgot something there.
And after you went back to get whatever that was, you then took your boss home?
Yes.
After you dropped your boss off, you and Jody, where did you and Jody go?
We went to Papa Don's.
And had you been to Papa Don's pub in the past?
Yes.
A couple times or?
Once or twice. Twice, yes.
And do you know why that was the choice of where to go after work that night?
Jody just knew friends there, so she asked if I'd take her there.
From going there a couple times, I guess you said, did you know any of the employees or anyone working there?
Some of the bartenders, yes.
Did you know Tiffany Miller?
I didn't know her personally, but I knew her from Papa Don's, yeah.
And did you know Justin Weinbrenner?
I met him that night.
You actually met him that night?
Well, yeah, he was at the bar, yeah.
Okay. Prior to that, did you know him?
No.
So you went from Portobello's restaurant after work there to your bosses and then back to your restaurant and then back to your bosses, and then you went to Papa Don's?
Yes.
And did you recall approximately what time you might have arrived at Papa Don's? When you guys arrived there, what area of the bar did you and Jody move to?
We went to the very back by the bathrooms, the very edge corner of the bar, right by the back office and the kitchen. And
okay. And we have up here State Exhibit 5. Have you seen this diagram before?
Yes.
And can you point to from where you are, or you can stand up, whatever works for you, point to the area where you and Jody were seated?
This is the bar, right?
Yes. There's the front door right there.
Right here.
Okay. You're pointing to right at the edge of the bar, the south end by that sort of where it turns into an L?
Yes.
Okay. From the time you arrive until, I guess, the time much later when you leave the bar, from the time you arrive to when shooting occurs, which we're going to talk about here in a moment, is that where you and Jody remain in that part of the bar?
Yes.
Did you ever get underneath that area?
I don't believe I did. Jody may have to talk to, she knew friends there, so she might have to talk to friends, but I stayed there.
At that time, on November, now it's early morning hours of the 16th, right? November 16th, 2014?
Yes.
Did you know at that time the defendant, Keenan Ivory?
No.
Hadn't seen him before that night?
No.
So what are you and Jody doing at, when you're sitting there at the bar?
She ordered some Vegas bombs and I had a beer. And we were just sitting there talking to some of her other friends were sitting on that L part, the kind that pops out a little bit. We were just sitting there talking to her friends.
I have to ask, Vegas what? Bomb?
Vegas bomb.
Vegas bombs.
Yes.
That's a mixed drink?
Yes.
Okay. And that's what Jody had?
Yes.
And you said you had a beer?
Yes.
At the time you were under 21?
Yes.
You knew that when you were at the bar?
Yes.
Okay. This is what we marked as State's Exhibit 36. Can you take a look at that for me? Describe what you see there.
We are sitting over here at the corner. Jody is faced towards the restrooms, and I'm sitting behind her. Keenan was sitting next to Jody.
So what State's Exhibit 36 is a still shot from the video that night?
Yes.
And have you watched the video of the shooting that night?
Yes.
Since it happened, obviously.
Yes.
All right, so you can identify yourself or see yourself in State's Exhibit 36 down at that, the last chair there, basically?
Yes. Yes.
If I point to about right there, is that you? you?
Yes.
And then Jody's, the dark hair sitting in front of you?
Yes.
You said that the defendant was sitting next to Jody?
Yes.
So while you were at the bar, there, seated at the bar with Jody, did you or Jody have any interaction with Keenan Ivory?
He started rubbing her back a couple times, and I just kind of looked at him and was like, "Will you stop doing that?" And he offered to buy us drinks and food, and we declined that and just avoided him for the rest of the night.
Okay, well, let me back up a little bit. So what's the kind of the first interaction you guys have with him? He just starts touching Jody, or is there a conversation?
No, there's no conversation. He was just rubbing her back, and then like we kind of looked at him, and he was like, "Do you want food or drink or anything?" And we were just said no. And then Joni kind of like put her arm on her head to kind of try and avoid him.
You said you offered to buy a drink. Did he do that?
No.
You and Joni said no to that?
Yes.
Did he touch Jody more than one time that you saw?
Yeah, a couple times.
Okay. From what you saw of him doing that and Jody's demeanor or reaction to that, was Jody indicating she wanted that to happen?
No.
Can you describe his general demeanor when he was interacting with you and Jody?
He was just intoxicated, just talking, hitting on a lot of girls, just trying to buy drinks for everyone. He had a big wad of money, he was trying to show off. Wasn't really acting like mean or angry at this point during the night, just trying to hit on people.
Okay. And you said he was acting intoxicated?
Yeah.
What do you mean by that?
He just kept taking, he had drinks, and how drunk people act, I don't know, they just hit, he was hitting on everyone, just,
Was his demeanor or behavior appropriate?
It wasn't.
Objection to the word appropriate.
Yeah, I'll sustain that if you'll rephrase.
From his actions towards you, how did you deem that?
They were nothing bad at this time during the night. He was just acting like he wanted to buy us drinks and trying to be friendly, I guess. But we didn't really, what's the word for it, accept it, like take anything from him.
You said you saw him either hitting on or trying to talk to other patrons or at the bar? Correct?
Yes.
Other females?
Yes.
Who else did you see him attempt to talk to or is your word hit on?
I don't know their names, but just girls throughout the bar. The one of them was Anna Marie, I think, and she was kind of across the bar at the end of the L on the bar.
Okay. You say Anne Marie. Did you know Anne Marie's name that night?
No.
Okay. You learned that subsequently?
Yes.
So you said that you're right at the corner of the L, correct? They did?
Yes.
And when you saw the defendant interacting with Anne Marie, or hitting on her, or whatever your words were, where is she standing or sitting?
She is standing almost walking behind the bar, but right on the corner of that L.
So if you're here, she's
about right there, yeah.
Here at the corner, here. Not inside the bar, but outside.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Okay, so what was the interaction, without telling me what she said, what was the interaction between Keenan Ivory and Anna Marie at that time?
He was just trying to buy her a drink as well, just trying to make conversation with her.
So you heard him talk to her or say words ever across the bar there?
Yes.
And as he's trying to talk to Anna Marie, what's her demeanor like after?
She's kind of, I don't know what, how you would put it. She didn't want to talk to him, didn't want anything to do with him, was just trying to avoid him, not really saying anything back at the beginning of it.
Okay. She does then say something back to him?
Yes.
And what is the defendant's reaction when Anne-Marie says something back to him?
He gets angry, says that he has authority, starts kind of laughing. No one really knows what he's talking about at this point, and he just keeps saying it over to himself. No one's really paying attention to him at this point.
Saying what to himself?
I got authority, I got authority. We thought we were he was talking about authority of beer at that time, so we were just kind of like, that, what is that going to do to anything?
So kind of,
you said
kind of laughing and saying, I got authority?
Mm-hmm.
So you say yes or no, I'm sorry?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
And you said he's kind of talking to who?
Just himself. Well, and the initial, the first, when he said, I have 40, it was directed towards Anne-Marie, but she stopped paying attention, and he just was kind of sitting there laughing to himself, just saying it over and over again to himself.
So did Anne-Marie stay where she was at the top of the L there? The
no.
Did you see where she went?
I personally did not. No, I didn't notice that she left.
When the defendant is saying that to himself or mumbling or laughing to himself, like you said, is Anne-Marie still there for that?
No, she leaves during the middle of it. I was paying attention to him. Everyone else around me was just conversating and talking with each other.
So at some point later on after that, the interaction you see between the defendant and Anne-Marie, that you see the defendant get up and leave the bar?
Yes. Tiffany, he gets up and Tiffany makes him leave, and he just leaves the bar, and we didn't think he was going to come back.
Do you hear any of the interaction or conversation between Tiffany and the defendant before he leaves?
No.
Do you see the defendant return to the bar, walk back in the doors and return to the bar?
No.
What is the first thing then that draws your attention back to noticing him back at the bar?
We started to hear like rustling and yelling, and there was a big Browns balloon in the corner, and I thought it was that popping, so that's what me and Jody heard. We were like, oh, there's a fight. And I kind of just like walked over to see a little bit, and then I saw one of the people who got shot ran by, and then me and Jody went in a closet with one of the bartenders.
So at first, when you hear bell noises or what you said was a pop or popping, do you understand what's going on, that there was a gun that's been fired?
No, we thought it was just a fight.
And you said one of the patrons ran past where you were either standing or sitting at the end of the bar there?
Yeah, at this point we were standing kind of in the middle because we didn't know what was going on. We kind of got up to walk towards and see what was happening. And then he ran past us and then we were like, oh, someone has a gun. So we went, I think her name's Tara, is one of the bartenders. She took us back into a closet with her where she called 911.
That person that kind of ran by you when you realized that someone had been shot, did you see injuries on him?
Yeah, he was bleeding. One of Jody's friends laid on top of him to try and stop the bleeding.
And as he's actually going by you, you see that there's blood coming out, you see bleeding?
Yes.
When you kind of figured out what had just happened, you're getting into that closet you said with Tara the bartender. Who's with you?
Jody and Tara.
Jody call, I'm sorry, is Tara call 911?
Yes.
You're there in the, I guess it's the office or back room?
Yes.
When you realize at that point, you see one of the patients actually shot and bleeding near you. What is your reaction?
I was scared. We just ran into this closet as fast as we could, trying not to deal with anything else.
Just get out of that area?
Yeah.
I want to ask you then, Natalie, when the defendant was seated next to Jody, so a seat away from you, did you ever see a gun on him at any time?
No.
Anywhere of the person when he's turning to talk to you guys?
No.
And after the shooting happens, you guys go in that closet or that office room. Do you ever come back out of there?
Yes.
Okay, what happens then?
They call in police. We're all just standing around trying to figure out like what exactly happened. The one man who got shot through the foot was sitting in a chair, and me and Jody went up and talked to him. And
where was he sitting in the chair?
He was kind of by the patio door. Should I use the stick?
Sure.
He was out right here.
Okay, so we're talking the top end of the L of the bar. He's in this area?
Yeah.
Okay. You said he was seated or standing?
He was seated.
At that time, did you have any contact with this Anne Marie? You didn't know her name, but did you see or talk to her at all again at that point?
Yeah, I went up to her and said that the defendant did say he had a 40 and that we didn't know what it meant at that time.
And why did you say that to Anne Marie?
Because she was across the bar, and I don't know if she had heard him say that. I think I was the only one who heard him.
And did you kind of put two and two together now, what 40 meant?
Yeah.
Not a drink, but
yeah.
Tossing a gun?
Yeah.
Okay, and you said before, I think I asked you, did you had a chance to review or watch the video from the surveillance cameras that night?
Yes.
You've had a chance to do that since the occurrence?
Yes.
I'm going to play a portion of State's Exhibit 4, which is camera 4 video for the witness. And
see that? And then there's a little button on the bottom if you'll turn it on.
Okay, just need to maybe walk out here and just take a look and see and tell us if you locate yourself in the still where it's set here at 159.23 on the counter.
Yes, I can.
Okay. Can you kind of point yourself there?
Right there.
Okay. Blonde hair, like a white shirt or something?
Yes.
White?
Yes.
Was your hair a little blonder?
Yes.
Okay. So, just to be clear, I'm a little taller than you, so I can point here. This is your hair?
Yes.
Alright. And, I'm going to play a short portion. Or just have her maybe stay there for this day?
Yeah.
159.23.
Thank you.
0003, and can you just point to where you were now, where you moved?
And right there.
Okay, so you moved down towards the, what was on the north end of the bar?
Yes.
Play again from there. You're going to stop there again at 2 and then 7, 2 0017. Who were you were just talking there?
Yes.
And who were you talking to?
Amber.
Okay, and what was it that you were saying at that point?
I said that earlier after she had a conversation with him that he did say he had a 40.
So that's when you just testified before when you walked out and talked to her, that's the moment we're talking about?
Yes. No, I do not. I know I was one of the last to be interviewed.
Like that night?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So you were interviewed actually that night after the shooting?
Yes.
Were you still at Papa John's?
Yes.
Okay, and just for the record, the person you're referring to is Keenan Ivory, that was seated next to you and Jody that night. Is he here in the courtroom today?
Yes.
So noted.
I have no further questions for you, just gentlemen, we have some.
Pardon?
You can turn the lights on.
Oh yeah, sorry.
Good afternoon, Ms. Lynn.
Good afternoon.
My name is John Grevin, and I'm one of the attorneys who represents Keenan, okay?
Yes.
I'm sure that they told you that another attorney might be asking you questions, right?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to ask you to do me two favors. One, I'm going to ask you to keep your voice up so the jurors all the way back here can hear you, although so far you're doing a really good job.
Okay.
And then secondly, if I ask you a question and you don't understand it, I want you to let me know.
Okay.
I will explain it, rephrase it, but it's important we're always on the same page, okay?
Okay.
All right. Now, you go to the bar, and I think you said you get there between 1 and 1:15. It's not super important, but around that time, correct?
Yes.
And the bar here is kind of an L-shaped bar, right?
Yes.
You take the last seat before the turn.
Yes.
Is that fair?
Mm-hmm.
And then Jody's seated next to you.
Yes.
And then he and I are seated right here, correct?
Yes.
And you said that there's also some people that are seated down here that you don't really know, but kind of friends of Jody's.
Yes.
And it's fair to say that this is more Jody's bar than your bar, correct?
Yes.
She's been there several times. I think you said you've only been there a couple of times.
Yes.
Okay. Now, you had mentioned during your direct examination the phrase hit on. Remember saying that a couple of times?
Yes.
All right. I'm going to guess you're 20, correct?
Yes.
All right. We have jurors and myself that range a wide variety of ages. Now, I'm going to guess a hit on may mean different things to different age groups.
Yes.
What do you mean by hit on?
Just trying to conversate with different women, trying to buy them drinks, just, I don't know another word other than hit on, just,
So when you say hit on, you mean trying to talk to somebody, correct?
Yes.
And maybe trying to buy them a drink, correct?
Yes.
Well, you agree a bar is a social gathering place, right?
Yes.
So, if one person is trying to talk to another person, that's not unusual, is it?
No.
In fact, it's certainly not unusual if a man is trying to talk to an attractive female, correct?
Yes.
That happens all the time. As far as buying a drink, again, you're an attractive young lady. Apparently, you have some experience in bars. Sometimes men ask women if they can buy them a drink, correct?
Yes.
Have they ever asked you if they could buy you a drink?
Yes.
And sometimes you say, sure?
Not usually, no.
Have you ever?
Yes.
Okay. So sometimes a man will ask a woman, hey, can I buy you a drink? And sometimes a woman says yes, and they have a drink together, correct?
Yes.
And sometimes a woman might look at the guy and say, no, thank you, and that's pretty much the end of it, correct?
Yes.
So you agree with me in this situation, when Keenan is talking to Jody, he is not angry or confrontational, correct?
No.
In fact, if anything, he's maybe overly friendly. Is that fair?
Yes.
Okay, and again, he's trying to talk to her, right?
Yes.
And he's trying to ask to buy her and you. Can I buy you guys a drink, right?
Yes.
And you say no.
Yeah.
And after you say no, after you shoot him down, you talk about Anne Marie.
Yes.
And Anne Marie was the person that you said you also saw Keenan hit on. That's the phrase you use, right?
Yes.
He asked to buy her. In fact, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, you were there, I wasn't. Keenan says to her, hey, come here. Right? Remember hearing that?
Yes.
And she says no.
Yes.
And he says, no, come here. And she says no. And then he says it a third time, and that's fine when she says, I have a boyfriend that's down there, right? Remember seeing that?
Yes.
Okay. And again, at that point in time, Keenan's just talking to her, trying to talk to somebody in the bar, right?
Yes.
Okay. There's nothing unusual about that, right?
No.
Okay. And eventually, Amory leaves, correct?
Yes.
But not until you hear Keenan say, this is important. Before we get into that, the prosecutor asked you about giving a statement that night. You actually give a statement right in the bar, right? They can keep everybody there. They don't let you leave until the detective talks to you, right?
Yes.
And you remember talking to Detective Ross?
I didn't know he was Detective Ross, but I did speak to a detective, yes.
Okay, you spoke to a white male detective in the patio area, probably?
It was at one of the booths on the edge by the patio, yes.
Okay, fair enough. And do you remember telling Detective Ross later he said that he had a .40 caliber? Remember that?
Yes.
And in fact, we just watched this video. And what you actually say in the video to Anne Marie is, not that after you left, he said he had a 40. Your words are, after you left, he said he had a 40 caliber, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So you don't just hear 40, you hear 40 caliber, correct?
Yes.
Now you agree with me, if you hear 40, you know what a 40 ouncer is, right?
Yes.
It's a beer, 40 ounce beer, right?
Yes.
You know what a 40 caliber is though, right?
Yes.
Vastly, so there's a big difference between a 40 and a 40 caliber, right?
Yes.
And clearly, he says before he is asked to leave that night, he clearly states, I got a 40 caliber on me.
Yes.
Okay. In your direct testimony, you said, we saw Keenan leave, and then you said, and we thought he was never coming back.
Yes.
I mean, did you really put that much thought into it at the time?
No.
Right. I mean, nobody sat around and said, well, he's not coming back, right?
Yes.
You never even, in fact, that thought never really went through your mind, right?
No.
No. You just saw him leave and said, he left, who cares?
Mm-hmm.
Fair?
Yes.
Okay. And you don't see the confrontation when he walks back in, right?
No.
And you don't see any of the action that leads up to this. You just don't see it. Is that fair?
Yes.
Okay. thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Your direct testimony, as Mr. Graham said, you used the word hit on, the defendant was trying to hit on you and Jody, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And then on cross, you stated you agreed with Mr. Bremen that he had to be talking to you and Jody, right?
Yes.
Okay. Was there a difference to you, being a woman, being in a bar, and in your experience, is there a difference between someone hitting on you and someone just talking to you?
Yes.
What is that?
Hitting on someone, I feel like you want us to, he was trying to buy us drinks. If I'm usually just talking to someone, they're not gonna, they might offer to buy me a drink, but usually I know them and I've never met him before. For him to just come up and randomly rub Jody's back and ask to buy us food and drinks, I felt like that was, I was being hit on.
When Mr. Brevin asked your question, and in it he stated, so defendant clearly stated to you, I got a .40 caliber on me. Were those the defendant's words, a .40 caliber on me?
No.
Those were not his words?
No.
What were his words that you heard?
I have a .40.
Not on me?
No.
Okay. And did you hear him say, I got a .40 caliber at some point?
No.
Okay. Why is it that you tell Anne Marie that you overheard him saying or mumbling to her, I got a .40 caliber?
After the shooting, I just put two and two together, not thinking that it was a .40, a beer, thinking that it was a .40 caliber.
Okay. So you never actually heard the word .40 caliber? No, you heard I got a .40 on, or I'm sorry, I got a .40.
Yes.
When the defendant was rubbing Jody's shoulder, touching her, trying to buy you guys drinks, in your words, hitting on you. Did you reject him?
Yes.
Did Jody reject him?
Yes.
And then did Anne Marie reject him?
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That rejection is not out of it, correct?
Yes.
I'm going to play this again. You don't really need to do the lights. It's for the volume, not.
Thank you.
like you said, I got a 40 caliber. That's what you said, correct?
Yes.
You did not say, you know, after you left, he said, I got a 40, and I thought he meant a beer. But now you must be talking about 40 caliber. You clearly said to her, you heard him say in the bar that he had a 40 caliber, right?
Yes.
Thank you.
Anything else?
No.
All right, thank you, ma'am. You can step down. That's it.
Judge, that's all the witnesses we have for today.
All right, we're going to end a little early today. We're going to start up tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. I'm going to remind you, so be in here in the jury room at 8:55. Remind you about all the admonitions. Don't discuss the case. Don't investigate the case. Don't make any final decisions on the case. And once again, don't commute any media, local news or online news locally. All right, all those admonitions. All rise. Just leave in the jury room and Shay will please you.
Thank you.